हेलो। हेलो
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 हेलो हेलो मैडम, सरदा मैडम,
सर ओके।
यूट्यूब
मैडम सीन्स स्क्रीन शेयरिंग के नाक एनेबल लेदु। हेलो
सर सर कैन यू हियर मी?
हाँ यस मैडम,
ఓకే
స్క్రీన్ షేరింగ్ ఈజ్ నాట్
పంపించండి।
ఎనేబుల్ టు మీ మ్యామ్।
ఓకే నాకు మెయిల్ చేయండి।
ఐ సెండ్ ఇట్ టు యూ।
ఓకే వన్ మినిట్ సార్।
మీకు మీకు వచ్చిందా?
వచ్చింది వచ్చింది।
అంటే స్క్రీన్ షేర్ మీకు అవుతుందా లేకుంటే హోస్ట్ హ్యాస్ టు డిసేబుల్డ్ అని వచ్చిందా? హోస్ట్ డిసేబుల్డ్ పార్టిసిపెంట్ స్క్రీన్ షేరింగ్ అని ఉంది।
ఒక్క నిమిషం, స్క్రీన్ షేర్ చేసే ఆప్షన్ ఉంది నాకు।
మీకుందా? అది హోస్ట్ నాకు ఇవ్వండి మేడం।
నేనేం చేయలేదే। ఎలా ఇవ్వాలి, దేనిలో ఉంటుంది చెప్పండి।
ఏమో మరి,
ఇద్దరికి ఇస్తారు కదా హోస్ట్,
నాకు ఇవ్వలేదు।
ఓకే సార్, నా ఇంట్లో లేదనుకుంటా సార్। ఎవరు
ఒకసారి మీకు మీకు వస్తుందా?
షేర్ స్క్రీన్ ఆప్షన్ అయితే నాకు కనిపిస్తుంది।
ఆప్షన్ కనిపిస్తుంది, ఓకే మేడం, దాని మీద క్లిక్ చేసినప్పుడు మన పార్టిసిపెంట్ నాట్ అనబుల్ నాట్ ఇది హోస్ట్ డిజేబుల్డ్ అని వస్తుంది, హోస్ట్ డిజేబుల్డ్ పార్టిసిపెంట్ సీన్ స్క్రీన్ అని।
ఒక్క నిమిషం, నేను ఇంకా క్లిక్ చేయలేదు।
మీరు క్లిక్ చేయండి
ట్రై
స్క్రీన్ మీద
సార్।
క్లిక్ చేయండి మేడం షేర్ స్క్రీన్ మీద, మీకు షేర్ అవుతుందా లేదా?
ఓకే అలాగే వస్తుంది.
అలాగే వస్తుంది కదా, హోస్ట్ డిజేబుల్డ్ పార్టిసిపెంట్ స్క్రీన్ షేరింగ్ అని. ఒకసారి హెచ్ఓడి సార్ కాల్ చేసి చెప్పండి మేడం.
ఓకే
నా మొబైల్తో నేను నెట్ కనెక్ట్ చేసి పెట్టాను.
ఓకే ఓకే 1 మినిట్స్ ఐ విల్ ఫైండ్ అవుట్. మీరు స్టార్ట్ చేయండి, మాట్లాడడం స్టార్ట్ చేసేయండి.
స్క్రీన్ షేర్ అయితే చేయొచ్చు మేడం.
అంటే ఇంకా స్టార్ట్ చేయలేదు అని క్వశ్చన్ చేస్తారు మామూలు.
ఆహా లేదా, నాకు పిపిటి షేర్ చేయాలి కదా ఫస్ట్.
అవును, ఐ థింక్ ఏమన్నా వాళ్ళే వాంటెడ్లీ చేశారో మాకు తెలియదు కదా, అందుకంటున్నాము.
ఓకే ఓకే, మీరు మాట్లాడండి సార్ చేస్తాను. నేనే చేసింట కానీ నా మొబైల్ నా దగ్గర లేదు, ఆడ పెట్టేసాను. హలో స్టూడెంట్స్, గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్ టు ఎవరి వన్. సో యూ ప్లీజ్ రీనేమ్ యువర్ నేమ్ టు యువర్ ఐడి. సో దెర్ ఆర్ సమ్ స్టూడెంట్స్ హూ కెప్ ద నేమ్, యూ చేంజ్ ఇట్ టు యువర్ రోల్ నెంబర్.
హుసేన్ సార్?
ఎస్ మ్యామ్.
ఇప్పుడు వస్తుంది, ట్రై చేసి చూడండి ఒకసారి.
నో మ్యామ్, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ గెటింగ్. మేక్ మీ యాజ్ ఎ హోస్ట్ సార్. సార్ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, మేక్ మీ యాజ్ ఎ హోస్ట్ సార్. ఐఎమ్ అనేబుల్ టు షేర్ మై పీపీటీ. ఓకే ఓకే మ్యామ్, ఐఎమ్ గెటింగ్ ఇట్ నౌ.
ఓకే
ఓకే డియర్, గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ స్టూడెంట్స్, ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ ప్లీజ్ రీనేమ్ యువర్ నేమ్ టు యువర్ రోల్ నెంబర్ సో దట్ అటెండెన్స్ విల్ బి మార్క్డ్. సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టూడెంట్స్ నాట్ రీనేమ్ దేర్ నేమ్. జయశ్రీ, హస్వంత్ శ్రీ, సాయి, కార్తికేయ, మనీషా, సచిన్ నాని, షేక్ అఫ్సద్, అష్ఫక్, శ్రీను. సో ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ ప్లీజ్ రీనేమ్ యువర్ నేమ్ టు యువర్ రోల్ నెంబర్.
హలో
ओके सेल आई स्टार्ट मैम
सर यू कैन स्टार्ट
ओके सो माई सेल्फ मिस्टर पी माबू हुसैन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ट्रिपल ई डिपार्टमेंट सो आई एम टेकिंग द कोर्स ऑन इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर ट्रांसमिशन सिस्टम्स राइट लेट अस गो टू इंट्रोडक्शन फॉर द कोर्स टुडे Right, upon completion of the course, a student will try to learn the mathematical solutions for the transmission line parameters for a single phase and three phase systems. And after completion of this course, the students will try to learn the mechanical design of overhead transmission lines and the use of insulators and underground cables in electrical power transmission system, and also the modeling of short, medium and long transmission lines, along with the study of transient behavior of these lines. And also the students will try to learn the need of EHVAC and HVDC transmission systems to meet the present day electrical power requirements. So these are the course objectives. After completion of this course, the student will try to learn all these objectives. Right. If you observe the syllabus for the course, so the syllabus is divided into five modules. Right. So the module one is about transmission line parameters. So in this first module, hello, please mute your audio, ma. All the participants, you please mute your audio. It is disturbing me. Roll number 231. Please mute your audio. Okay. So module 1 is about transmission line parameters. In this unit, you are going to study about what are the different types of conductors and there are line parameters, mainly resistance, inductance and capacitance of the transmission lines. So you can also discuss about the skin and proximity effects and the calculation of resistance, inductance, capacitance for single phase lines, three phase lines and three phase. In three phase also you have symmetrical lines and asymmetrical lines. For all these three lines you are going to calculate the inductance and capacitance. You are also have the bundled conductors in transmission system. For that also you will determine the capacitance and inductance. All these are derived, the inductance formulas and capacitance formulas will be derived in this unit. Okay, so entire thing about first module is derivation of inductance capacitance for different types of transmission lines. Okay, right. In the second module you are going to design the transmission lines. So you are going to study the mechanical design aspects of transmission lines. So under this you are going to study the different types of insulators used for the transmission system and string efficiency and methods for improving this string efficiency. And you can also determine the different methods to achieve the uniform voltage distribution across the string of insulators. And you will also do some sag calculations and tension calculations, right? And you will also consider the different weather conditions, effect of wind, ice on the ice coatings on the conductors. So you will consider all these effects and you will find the string efficiency, and you will also determine the sag and tension for different transmission lines. Okay, so you will also study the stringing chart and sag template. So these two are very important while designing the transmission lines system. Right, module 3. So module 3 is focuses on performance of transmission line. Performance in the sense you are going to determine the efficiency, right? So transmission lines are classified into different types: short, medium and long. Depending upon the length of the transmission line, they are divided into short, medium and long transmission line. For all these short, medium and long transmission lines you are going to study the performance. That means in the performance in the sense you are going to study the efficiency and voltage regulation of these lines by using different methods, right? So you are going to study the nominal T method, nominal pi method and ABCD constants are also used for calculating the performance of the lines, right? For the long transmission lines you are going to observe the performance by using a rigorous solution. Okay, and you will also study the Ferranti effect and propagation of wave, surge impedance, all these in the third module, right? So third module mainly focuses on the performance of transmission lines. You are going to study the efficiency and regulation of all types of transmission lines, which are short, medium and long transmission lines, right? So the next module, fourth module, so will be focuses on power system transients, right? The transients will occur on the power system. So what are the different factors governing power system transients, and at the same time what is the performance of transmission lines and the effect of these transients on the performance of the transmission lines, right? In the transients you are going to study what is the incident wave, what is the reflected wave and refracted wave. So what are the different types of transients and traveling waves, right? And you will study the mainly Bailey's lattice diagram, which is an important diagram for determining the transient behavior of the power system network. And also you are going to study the corona. So corona will be formed on the overhead transmission line. So what are the different factors affecting the corona? So what is the advantages of corona and what are the disadvantages of corona? What is the radio interference, right? All these will be studied in this unit, right? Fourth module will be mainly focuses on power system transients as well as the concept of corona. And the last unit, fifth module. So in this module you are going to study the underground cables and EHVAC and EHVDC transmission systems. Okay, so what are the different types of underground cables and what is the construction of these cables, and calculation of insulation resistance, stress in insulation, right, and capacitance of single core and the three core cables. All these will be studied in this module. Okay, so along with these underground cables you are also study the need of EHVAC transmission system and HVDC transmission system in India, and as also you will compare the AC and DC transmission systems. So then you will outline the advantages of DC transmission system over AC transmission system. Okay, so these are the different concepts we will study in module 4. Okay, this is about the entire syllabus. So your entire syllabus will be divided into 5 modules, right. Next, what are the textbooks you will prefer for this course, right? So these are the different types of textbooks. So CL Vadva, Electrical Power Systems, DP Kothari, Eisen Agarath, these are power system engineering and McGraw Hill Education, and VK Mehta and Rohit Mehta, Principles of Power Systems. So D Das, Electrical Power Systems, Turin Gogan, Electrical Power Distribution System Engineering, V Kamaraju, Electrical Power Distribution Systems, JB Gupta, a course in Power Systems. So these are the different textbooks you can refer for this course, right? So I highlighted the first 2-4 textbooks. So generally we will prefer these first 3 courses, so which will be helpful for the students. I'm also using these 4. Okay. Right. So here onwards you focus. So let us see the structure of your power system here. So all student, you concentrate from here onwards. Okay, what is the structure of your power system? If you observe the structure of your power system network, so power system mainly deals with the electrical power generation, transmission and utilization of electrical energy. Okay, the power system mainly deals with generation of electrical energy, transmission of electrical energy and distribution of electrical energy, as well as utilization of electrical energy, right? So now if you see the structure, it will look like this, from generating power plant to your household appliances. Okay, so initially you have the power plant. In power plant you have a large generators, and you will generate the voltage at a voltage of 11 kV or 33 kV. Okay, at power plants, in the sense these power plants may be hydel power plants, nuclear power plants or thermal power plants or any solar or wind power plants. Okay, so these power plant may be any type, it may be non renewable or renewable. Right, in the power plant you will generate the electrical energy at some specific voltage, right? So generally the generated voltage is will be in the range of 11 kV to 33 kV. So in some power plants they will generate the 11 kV, in some more power plants they may be generating 33 kilovolts. So this is about the generating power plant, right? After generating the voltage which is of order of 11 kV or 33 kV, so here near to this power plant you will have one substation which is called generating substation. In that generating substation you will have a step up transformer. Okay, so step up transformer will step up the voltage of 11 kV or 33 kV to higher voltages. The higher voltages may be 132 kV or 220 kV or 400 kV. Okay, at generating station you will be having one step up transformer. So that step up transformer will step up the voltage level of the generating voltage. So if you are generated the voltage at 11 kV or 33 kV, it will be stepped up to either 132 kV or 220 kV or 400 kV. Okay, so now at this higher voltage levels your electrical power will be transmitted to the longer distance. Okay, so the transmission of electrical power, so from here 133 kV to up to this step down transformer. So these electrical power will be transmitted through transmission lines. So these transmission lines are supported by the towers. Okay, if your voltage is very high then you will use the towers. If your voltage is less for distribution system you may use the poles. Okay, so generally higher voltage we will build the towers, right? So on the electrical power will be transmitted through these lines, right? After going some distance, so your voltage may be reduce. So to maintain the voltage you may be having another substation here. So generally substation, in the sense, in the substation main device is the transformer. Okay, so you may be having a transmission substation here in which you are having a step down transformer, right? So this step down transformer will step down the voltage, which is of 132 or 222 or 400 kV volts to 66 kV. Okay, so primary voltage will be very high, which is 132, 220 or 400 kilovolts, and this will be stepped down to 66 kilovolts. Okay, so now this 66 kilovolts will be transmitted to some more distance, right? And it will be taken to the distribution substation here. Okay, here you are having that transmission substation. Here you may be having distribution substation, right? Here in every substation, as I said, you will be having the main component as a transformer. So with the transformer is a step down transformer. So this step down transformer will step down the voltage to still lower level. So 66 kV will be still reduced to 11 kV or 3.3 kV or 6.6 kV. Okay, right. Now till now, from power plant to this step down transformer, which is at a voltage of 11 kV, up to this you are not going to take any tappings, right? So this from power plant to this step down transformer, so power plant here, from here to this, right? Right, so from this power plant to up to this step down transformer, from here to here, you are not going to take any tappings from the these lines. You are not going to take any tappings. You are not connected any loads here. So this is called the transmission system. Okay, so our main course is this one, transmission only. Okay, up to this you are not going to take any tappings, or you are not going to connect any load. So you will be transferring the power from electrical power station to a substation which is far away from the power plant. Okay, so now from this step down transformer, you are going to distribute the electrical power, okay, to consumers or industries. Okay, so at this step down transformer, your voltage is, secondary voltage is 11 kV or 3.3 kV or 6.6 kV also. Okay, at this voltage, some of the industries will take the 11 kV and some of the industries will take the 3.3 kV. Some of the industries will take the 6.6 kV. So depending upon the type of the industry, whether the industry is a large scale industry or small scale industry, or it is having any commercial loads, right? So in such a case, depending upon the type of the industry, they will take the 11 kV or 3.3 kV or 6.6 kV. Okay, so now the voltage will be transmitted at this voltage to up to another transformer, right? So which is called a distribution transformer again. So from here, from this transformer, you are going to reduce the voltage still. That means this 11 kV or 3.3 kV will be still reduced to 400 volts or 440. So this will be given to the commercial loads, small commercial loads, or single phase voltage also will be given to the household purpose. Okay, domestic loads will generally take the single phase, right? From this transformer, from the last transformer, you will be getting a three phase voltage. So and the lines here you are getting here is the four lines, right? At the last step down transformer, the secondary of the last step down transformer will have the four lines. Okay, up to this primary of this transformer, up to the primary of this transformer, you may be having only three lines. Okay, you may not have the neutral line, right? R phase, Y phase, B phase, and a neutral line. So the secondary distribution transformer will be having these four lines, right? So if any commercial load requires three phase supply, they will take these all three phases. And if you take the domestic loads will generally take the single phase supply. So the domestic load will be connected to any of these three lines and one neutral, right? So if you want to connect your household load, you will take B phase and neutral. Some other person may take Y phase and neutral. Okay, when you require the single phase voltage, you will take one phase and neutral as your lines. Okay, So this is the structure of your power system network. Okay. So you have the generation, right? So generation voltage is 11 kV or 33 kV. So most preferably 11 kV may be generated, and this generating voltage will be step up at the power station, a power plant, by using step up transformer. So it will be stepped up to a higher voltage of, which is 400 kilovolts. So it may be 400 kilovolts, or it may be 133 kV, or it may be 220 kV. Okay, at the step up transformer, which is located in the near to the power plant, right? So you will step up the voltage. So then you will transmit the voltage to certain distance, and you will again step down the voltage. So step up transformer will be there only in the generating station. So remaining all transformers are step down transformers only. So now this 400 kilovolts will may be step down to 66 kV. Okay. So from here, from generation to this, so this is called the transmission. So this is the transmission. So now from 66 kV again you will transfer the power to some more distance, and here you will be having another step down transformer, so which step down the voltage to 11 kV or still lower, 6.6 kV or 3.3 kV, right? So during the transmission you are not going to connect any load. Okay, so then from here onwards, from this transformer up, you will connect the loads. So you may connect the large industrial loads or small industries, right? So here you may connect the industrial load. Okay, so then to go for the domestic loads, so you will be again having one more step down transformer. So this step down transformer will step down the voltage to 440 volts three phase, so which is having three phases, RYB phases and one neutral line. So if you want three phase supply, you can take the three phase supply, which is at 440 volts, and if you want single phase supply will be of 230 volts. So this is about the structure of the power system network. Right. So now see the state power sector division. Any state, whether Telangana or Andhra Pradesh or any other state. So if you observe the divisions of this power sector, so later I am taking here Andhra Pradesh power sector. So right, this Andhra Pradesh power sector will be divided into these. You will be having one regulation body, so which is Andhra Pradesh Electricity Regulatory Commission. So this board, this regulation body will regulate or give the instructions or instructions to what is the voltage levels, right? It is a regulatory body for all these. Okay, and you will be having the generation. For generation you will have one board, which is AP Genco. Or for Telangana it is having TS Genco, right? So this Genco will deal with the production of electrical energy as well as the maintenance of electrical power plants, right? So these all will be dealt with this Genco. Okay, so production and maintenance of electrical energy will be dealt by this Genco. And you will be having another body, which is Transmission Corporation of Andhra Pradesh or Telangana, AP Transco or TS Transco. So this Transco will deal with the transmission of electrical energy. Okay, it will mainly deals with the construction of towers or transmission lines. Okay, so maintenance of these transmission lines all will be dealt by this Transco. Okay, after transmission you will be having distribution. Okay, so distribution, so you will be having EPDCL and SPDCL in Andhra Pradesh. In Telangana you will having the central CPDCL, Central Power Distribution Corporation Limited, and NPDCL, Northern Power Distribution Company Limited. Okay, these are the distribution companies, right? So these will take care of the distribution of electrical power to industries and household purposes. Hello, mute your audio please. రైట్ ఓకే but don't turn on your audio please right if you take any state the state power sector will be divided into different divisions so such as regulation about regulatory body generation for generation you will be having one genco and for transmission you have one transco and for distribution you may be having distribution companies which are EPDCL and SPDCL okay so generation that genco will deal with the generation of electrical energy and its maintenance and transco deals with the transmission of electrical energy and construction of towers and its maintenance and distribution companies will deal about the distribution of electrical energy to the industries and consumers industries and domestic consumers right so now if you observe the Indian electricity grid scenario right so our India India is divided into five regions okay northern region northeast region eastern region west region and southern region right first initially you have the states right here state power sector units we were discuss right so each state will be having its own electricity bodies right so by mixing a few states so by interconnecting the states a few states we are forming one region right by taking some of the state into one unit so we are taking it as a one region so like that whole India is divided into five regions which is northern region southern region western region eastern region and northeast region okay so these are the five regions which the India was divided right so now initially these are operated individually so that means there is no interconnection between any two regions okay so then after in October 1991 so northeastern region and eastern region so NER and ER these two are interconnected right initially you have five regions right so now in 1991 you are interconnected these two northeast region and eastern region so these two are interconnected so before interconnection of these two regions there is no electrical power transmission between these two regions only the state which are in the northeastern region they only can be shared the power right so but they cannot be shared they can share the power with next region which is eastern region right so but in 1991 these two are interconnected so the electrical power transmission can be occurred between these two regions right so then after March 2003 so this western region is interconnected with the northeast region and eastern region right initially these two northeast region right initially these two are interconnected in 1991 right in March 2003 so for these two western region also will be interconnected here okay so then in August 2006 so north region also will be interconnected with all these three so that a central grid is formed so that means when all the regions are interconnected that means which is meaning that they all the generators which are working in all those regions will be synchronously connected and they will be maintaining only one frequency okay right so up to 2006 only four regions are interconnected so except the southern region which is our region so before 2006 up to August 2006 you are having four region which is commonly we will call it as a central grid okay so till 2013 December so we were not interconnected southern region is not interconnected to the any other region that means there is no sharing of power between southern region to other regions okay so in December 31st 2013, the southern region also will be interconnected to this central grid. So with the 765 kilovolts transmission line, which is built between Raichur and Solapur. Okay. So now, after December 2013, so we are having all the five regions interconnected together, and so our nation has become one grid and one frequency. Okay, now we are operating our nation as a one grid and one frequency, right? Before 2013, you will be having only four regions interconnected. So those four regions only will be having one frequency, and southern region may not be connected to central grid, so it will be having some other frequency. So but as of 2013 December, as it is also southern region also will be connected to central grids. Now all the five regions are interconnected, and now we are getting entire nation, we are having only one frequency and one grid, which is called the national grid. Okay. So this is about the introduction of electrical power system. So still now you have any doubts, you can ask me. హలో మేడం కంటిన్యూ చేయాలా ఇది, ఇక్కడ వరకు ఆపేద్దామా? నెక్స్ట్ ఐ విల్ జస్ట్ గివ్ ఎన్ ద ఇంట్రడక్షన్. షల్ ఐ స్టార్ట్ ద ఫస్ట్ యూనిట్ మ్యామ్? హలో హలో ఓకే. సో టిల్ నౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఇంట్రడక్షన్. సో ఇన్ ఫ్రమ్ టుమారో ఆన్వర్డ్స్ వీ విల్ స్టార్ట్ ద ఫస్ట్ మాడ్యూల్, విచ్ ఈస్ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ లైన్ పారామీటర్స్. ఓకే రైట్. ఇన్ దిస్ క్లాస్ వీ వర్ డిస్కస్డ్ అబౌట్ ద syllabus and structure of the power system network. So what are the different state power sectors and divisions, our national grid. Okay, so here if you are having any doubts, you can raise your doubt either through chat box, or you can also speak. Yes. Regulation you will be having speed regulation. If you take the generators or motors, you may be studied in electrical machines speed regulation. So which is the change in speed with respect to the full load speed. Okay, when you are connected the load to your electrical generator, so then what may happen, your voltage at the load may drop, right? So this voltage regulation also you are studied in your electrical machines, right? So at the generator terminals you will be generating the voltage at an EMF of E, right? Right. So if you take a generator here, right, at the terminals of the generator you are having a voltage of E, right? So you are going to connect these generator terminals to a load here, right? So when you connect the load to this generator, so then during this transmission of electrical energy from generation to the load, so there may be some voltage drop will occur. So due to resistance of the lines or due to inductance of the lines, right? So there may be some voltage drop will occur. So the voltage which you are getting across the load is V, which is this V is less than the E. So why? Because there will be some voltage drop in the transmission system. Okay. So now the change in voltage from E to V, what is the change in voltage with respect to the full load voltage? So that is called the voltage regulation. Okay, so voltage regulation is the change in voltage, which is nothing but E minus V, so which is expressed as a fraction of full load voltage. So this is the voltage regulation. Okay, so if you want in percentage, you have to multiply it with 100. క్లియర్ రోల్ నెంబర్ 209 ఆస్క్ ద డౌట్ ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ మా స్టిల్ ఎనీ డౌట్స్ So tomorrow onwards we will start the first unit. So this is today is just an introduction about the course. Someone raised a hand. 248. So you can speak, ma. No problem. You unmute your audio and you can speak. Two 48 is Sierra.
Sir, I am Sierra of Section E.
Sierra of Section E. Who is?
Tejas 217.
217.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Ma, Sierra, so you create one group for both the sections. You create one group for both the sections. So why? Because we are taking the online classes combinedly together A and B. So you create only one group for A and B. So that if I want to send any messages or any information, so I will share to you. So even the PPTs, okay. 17.
Okay, sir.
Okay, ma. So you inform to other sections yours also.
Yes, sir.
You make them as a whether you create the Telegram group or a WhatsApp group.
WhatsApp, sir.
Huh? WhatsApp group. So, okay, in WhatsApp group, you make the other CRs also as admins. You ask them to add their class students.
Yes, sir.
Okay, by today you do it. I will share this PPT content, everything in the WhatsApp group.
So okay, sir.
It will be useful to you later.
Okay, sir.
Right. Is there any questions, ma? Shall I stop here? So no doubt still now. Okay, I'm ending the session tomorrow.
కానీ చేసుకుంటే మనకి టార్గెట్ పోతుంది మీకు క్యూరియర్ ఉంటే యూనిట్
ఎప్పుడు
మాకు జీతం ఉండదు ఇల్లు జీతం మాట్లాడి చేస్తేనే పెట్టాను చార్జెస్ కాదు కదా
ఏం బాగా నడు ఎంతసేపు ఉంటావు?